Yo, what's good, everybody? Thanks so much for tuning in. Get off the couch. Episode 6, Evil Ebenezer. If you guys want to see more videos, you can't wait for Get Off the Couch to pop. Go to stompdown.ca, you guys, capital Q's, always putting out videos. Ephin.com, all the music, rap, art, everything's updated on the regular. You guys want to get some of the fresh gear you guys are seeing in the videos, EphinStore.com, you guys, we ship that stuff worldwide. I don't care where you are, we will send it, all right? All right, I don't want to take up any more time. Evil Ebenezer's come up to the studio. We're going to get him on the couch. We're going to have a little drink, see what's in the fridge, ask him a bunch of questions that you guys posted on Facebook. Get off the couch. If I know Evil, I know what's going to be chilling in the fridge right now, some frosty brews. I'm going to check it out right now, see what we got. Let's get it started. Yeah, just what I thought. We're going to get our boo on. Caribou. Delicious. So here we are, episode 6. Gonna get my homeboy, Evil Ebenezer. I know you love him. I know you guys want to know a lot more about him because you guys posted a ton of questions. So I'm gonna get through as many as we can in the short period of time that we got. Sip a bunch of brews. Gonna have a good time. Thanks so much for tuning in. Evil Ebenezer, buddy, get up here, homeboy. Welcome, homie. Welcome.
Thanks for having me out.
Welcome to the couch.
Yeah, awesome.
Watching all the episodes.
Yeah?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, you like?
Yeah,
your totally. Group?
Yeah, you guys are doing something cool. I like it.
What do you got there?
All right, just bring a couple. I see you got the caribou there. Just bring a couple caribou stickers. Can I throw one on the fridge? Or?
Oh, please do, man. Please do. If you guys want to send us any of your stickers, head to effin.com, find our mailing address, send us your stickers. I'll slap them right here on the fridge, do a little close-up every time, get your sticker in the next episode, all right? Thanks, man. There's lots of frosty booze in there. You want to get your boo on or what?
Of course, man.
Boom!
Thanks so much to everyone that hit up Facebook, the Get Off the Couch page on Facebook. Got a ton of questions. I'm going to do my best to burn through as many as I can. We got an unreal prize pack this time around, too. Evil was nice enough. He, you threw in, got one of your, two of your albums?
I think we put Call Me Evil and Evil Eye in there, so.
Nice. We got a Camel Bear DVD in there as well.
Yeah.
Bunch of stickers. We got Hand Styles from Craver, Lesson, a poster. Bunch of Big Miles and KeepSix, whole cars on a poster, Hand Styles, the whole shebang.
It's a really good prize pack. I just saw it downstairs.
And gonna get her started right and now. Luke McLaughlin, Lawlin, maybe? What age did you start and why?
I was about probably 17 or 18. Just rapping, you know what I mean? Freestyling at parties. I wasn't really writing songs or anything.
Yeah.
But I say when I was about 24, I started writing songs.
Yeah.
So I was a bit of a late starter, I guess. Yeah.
Steven Beam wants to know, Eb, you sure seem grounded. What keeps you humble and cool as hell?
I'd say just fucking the friends and family around me, you know what I mean? All the people that I rap with are some of my best friends. Everyone that we run with, everyone that we do with is all pretty chill people, so
nice.
It's pretty easy to be humble, you know?
Jacob, not even gonna try this last name. Sjöström?
Oh, that's one of those Swedish.
That's foreign, eh?
Swedish hockey player name.
What does a normal day for you look like?
I mean, if I'm at home, I'm pretty much I'm chilling out. I mean, when I get up in the morning, like first thing I do is open up the fridge and take out a nice cold boo. No, I'm trying to work on music though. I mean, a lot of the time it preoccupies my mind. I'm working on my I'm the evil empire, you know what I mean? So
yeah.
It's not just the music, you know. I'm working on graphic stuff, it could be website, I'm working on videos, I'm
right
doing
on,
treatments,
right on.
You know. I'm steadily always grinding on the empire.
Daryl Kettler to Evil Ebenezer. Beside making music, what other passions in life do you have?
Sports. I'm a big sports fan. I got all the sports packages at home, so I got the hockey on, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, it's all on there. Darts, fuck.
Darts, fuck?
Just kidding. I know I was blown away though. The darts were on and like everyone that's at the darts, it's packed.
Yeah.
It's like 30,000. They're all just drunk English dudes like having
people
the best
take their darts
time.
Seriously, man.
Yeah, dude.
James Leno, if you were given the chance to do a track with anyone, dead or alive, who would it be and why?
It's a tough one. I would say probably someone like Kurt Cobain.
Oh, fuck.
Just,
oh, wow.
Yeah, yeah, just really great songwriter. Like, honest, really. Those kind of lyrics.
Back to the 90s.
Yeah, well, those kind of lyrics that he wrote, like, they seem so simple. Those are, like, the hardest lyrics to write because, and they have multiple meanings and shit like that. So, as far as, like, a lyricist, I find his lyrics are sick.
I think I'm going to get another boo. You need another boo?
Yeah, boo me.
Boo.
Ooh.
Antonio Cubis. Cubis? Cubis? Evil, do you do graff, or have you ever tried?
No, you know what? I never did graffiti. I've always had friends that have always done it. I used to draw and like, I did like tags, like in my notebook, like everybody, you know? Yeah. I've actually been writing Evil since I was like, or like that name, since
really?
I was about 15, 16.
Where did that name come from?
Evil was just a name that I got given to, from friends and stuff like that when I was younger, just at a party. I remember, I know Stu was there, Stewie Kubrick. Some guy was puking in the bathroom and like we were all there and like kind of like laughing and joking around and I remember I was just freestyling and I was like, oh, fucking lightweight Larry, you know, like, and then this one girl's like, you're evil. And I'm just like, I'm evil G, bitch. And then honestly, Ebenezer came out like quite a few years ago and it was just kind of like, you know, it just kind of happened. You know what I mean? I needed a last name too, so just to make it easier to search for me on the internet.
Now, getting back to Stewie Kubrick, you guys do a lot of work together. There's a name. Is there a name for your guys' little clique?
Yeah, the Draft Dodgers.
Dodgers.
And that's basically, it's mostly Stewie Kubrick and Vaughn Oliver, DJ U-Turn.
Yep.
And he's a pretty big producer now. He does a lot of like electro type shit. He's living down in LA now. Yeah, me and Stewie have known each other since high school. We used to make videos together in fucking in grade 12. You know,
really?
English or whatever.
No way.
Yeah, so.
Just for example, just one of the many projects you guys worked on. YouTube, Crush, Bruise, right now. I mean, Snack and Evil Kill It, obviously, on the track. Stewie does just such a great job at it. You guys gotta check that out if you haven't already seen it. What are you doing living under a rock? Seriously. James Lano. Recording tracks or freestyling? Which is better and why? Anytime there's any sort of beat going on, I mean, it could be anything.
Hopefully these are kicking around too, the AZ.
Yeah,
freestyle juice for sure. You know what?
Like, what do you like better though?
Well, obviously, I like them both for different reasons. I love to write music because that is something that you know, it's something that you feel and you think about, you write. But something about getting in a cypher and kicking in a freestyle and having that kind of that live interaction, like saying something that's just in the moment and it, you know, you get high off of it.
Yeah, we come up in the scene, yo, we some vandals. I just picked up homie's dirty sando. I'm about to throw that shit in the fire because that sando is retired.
Crater 1, UMD. If you had a rewind remote in your life to erase your mistakes, what would be the time that you would go back to?
That's the thing though, is that's what life's all about. It's about making mistakes and you learn from them, right? So I wouldn't go back and change anything. I am who I am because of the mistakes I've made, you know? Yeah.
Ohans Rosenquist Wine Koof?
German, maybe Swiss.
Man.
They do a big there. These names are the next level.
Yo Benz. Is that a nickname or what?
I don't know, Benz.
These things get personal.
Uncle Benz or...
What is the ultimate pro tip you can give?
Pro tip? Just carve your own lane, man. You know, be your own G, you know? That's all I can say is be original. I mean, look at our whole cap. You know, Craver, Lesson, everybody, you know, Nax, everyone that's... all the writers that are down with Ephin and SDK, all the rappers, we're all original. Yeah. Caspian, Snack, Evil, Sin, no one's alike.
With that being said, I want to know, what do you do when you get off the couch? I mean, you're a busy man, you're going to be on tour pretty quick.
Yeah, I'm in the studio, man.
Yeah?
That's what I do, I gotta work. We're finishing a song on the record, it's called Welcome Home.
Okay.
And for all y'all that don't know, my album coming out is called The Birds.
Okay.
And it's a free album.
Okay.
And it's going to be available December 6th, 2011.
What do you mean? The whole album is free?
The whole album is free. I'm giving this away to the fans.
How many tracks?
Well, I don't know. We're going to have about 15, 16 tracks on there. All brand
what?
New.
What?
No one's heard any of it. December 6th, 2011. Pardon? Free. The Birds is going to be on effin.com.
Crazy. So we're going to go check out a little bit of The Birds.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Welcome Home.
Welcome Home, yeah.
Co-Speak Studios.
Snack the Ripper.
Snack the Ripper.
See you soon, bro.
Grab get booed out and we'll go.
Let's go.
All right, let's do this.
Heading to the studio. See you soon.
Dude, I would take flight away from all the hurt I felt from being so afraid that I couldn't be myself. I never knew true love before. I was lost and ignored, so it's hard to trust somebody. I'd just rather cut somebody.
So this is Hometown Studio for Evil Ebenezer?
This is Coast Peak Productions.
Don't.
Yeah, Bluebird 32.
Is this the chipmunk?
Roger, this is the chipmunk.
Sound like the fucking squirrel to me.
Just let me in, man.
All right.
When I'm home on tour, I'm here. So I try to be here, like, you know, at least 2-3 days a week.
In this day and age, you gotta stay active. You know what I mean? You gotta be in the studio. You gotta be making music. That's just the only way to survive. So.
I'm in it to win it. I spin it and puff it. I keep it 100.
Hey, it's me. I'm just with the GOTC, Craver, and everybody.
We're here to record a couple tracks.
Just let me put my pants on real quick, and I'll let you guys right in, okay?
I make things better, but we all fucking liars. Sleeping in the attic, woke up to some blood-sucking spiders.
Yeah, everything you wish you had.
Come on in, guys. This is Coast Peak Studios.
Dope. Graham's been nice enough to let us kick back at Coast Peak Studios, Vancouver, BC. Get off the couch, baby. Nico Monge Shefford, ever consider doing other music apart from hip-hop, such as drum and bass?
Probably not, Nico. I'm pretty much locked into hip-hop as far as what I feel and what I do, but definitely doing more stuff. I'm singing a lot more and just experimenting more in that way, but drum and bass, no.
Emily Thurber, Evil, when you're alone, what songs do you sing? And then she added a little emoticon. It's like a little face with a tongue sticking out.
Oh yeah. You know what? I sing a lot of kind of older music, stuff that I maybe like hear on the radio or like 80s music. I hear the secrets that you keep, na na na, when you're talking in your sleep. You know, just shit like that, I don't know, anything that kind of like came out of that genre, or those days. The hair metal, the Poison, the fucking the White Snake, the fucking the AC/DC. I'm back in black.
Marvin Lerna, who are some of the artists you listened to before you started rapping, and which artists had the biggest impact in your style of rapping?
I used to listen to a lot of. At first, it was a lot of. Tribe Called Quest actually was the first group that I really liked. It was actually the first verse I ever learned, a rap verse I ever learned. It was for a talent show, and it was Scenario, and it was Charlie Brown's verse. The kind of like newer underground West Coast shit I was really feeling and definitely influenced by. So definitely Swole Members, Dilated Peoples, Tribe Called Quest. Just coming to some of the early hip-hop.
Know my way around, you fucking amateurs are stranded. The high is endless, my supplies is demanded. Burned into my flesh, the fucking animal was branded. So here we go, gonna give it all I got. No more standing in the trenches with the shovel in the ground.
Liam Rohan, dear Ebenezer. Really polite, hey?
That's nice, I like that.
Yeah. How has your life progressed along with your music from Call Me Evil to Evil Eye?
Wow, you know what? It's actually progressed in a lot of ways. I feel like I've personally progressed, like just like in like my music and everything, but just like my family and everyone, like, and when I say family, I mean like people that support me, like Ephin and SDK and Camel Bear Records and Caribou Brewing, people like that, just like supporters, sponsors, just people like that, like believe in me or are helping me pushing my music forward. A lot of that's happened since Call Me Evil. Just getting more independence within myself. I've had to do a lot of things by myself, but luckily I have people that are around me, like especially, I mean, F and I've been down with them since the beginning, right? 2002, they were the first people that came at me that kind of like helped me out. So,
how's the rejection game? That must get hard after a while, eh?
It's the worst, but you know what? You gotta really, and part of it I learned from my dad, because my dad was a musician, but you gotta develop a thick skin in this business, you know what I mean? So many people that hate you, and so many people that wanna put you down and don't want you to succeed. It's whether that comes from people in the business or it comes from relationships, like girlfriends or friends or from acquaintances or forever. You got to have those, you got to have that, you know, you got to have those tunnel blinders, you know what I mean? You got to really be able to just believe in yourself. And I got to tell you this, for a long time I didn't believe in myself, you know. There was a couple years that went by that I didn't know that this wasn't going to happen. But now, in the last couple years, I really believe that this is something that I was born to do. And now that I have the family and the support behind me, I'm ready to do it.
Another part of that question from Liam. How did you first meet Josh Martinez?
Josh Martinez, I met back in 2004, 2005. Originally, we put out my first album in 2005. It was called The Draft Dodgers Present Evil. And it was my first album. We actually got nominated for a West Coast Music Award back in 2005. And he heard that album, and you know, and he came to me and he talked to me, and I knew of Josh Martinez, but I'd never met him or anything. He's like, you know what, I really like this album, and I really think you have something special. And he's like, I'd love to maybe re-put out this album on Camel Bear Records. And then I was like, okay, cool. And then I added a couple new songs. I added Ha Ha Ha, which everyone knows that one, and I added that She Made Me song, and a couple other little things, and then we re-put out the album, called it Call Me Evil, and it came out in 2006 on Camel Bear Records.
Your face cut, fuck what they said, boy, I never gonna lose, nah. Rather jump off the Lions Gate Bridge wearing concrete boots, everything I loved in my life gone in a quick flash poof, catch me running around the fire range screaming go ahead,
Stephen
shoot.
Beam, Evil Ebenezer. Here's my two-part question. When it comes to putting together a track, everyone has their own process. How do you put together your tracks so they sound as you envision them? For example, listen to the beat, write the verses, and then add the hook? With that said, how do you pick a hot beat? You want to talk about that a little bit, or?
Yeah, sure. I think, well, it all starts with the beat selection for me. I find a bunch of music that I want to listen to and that people send me or whatever, and it really just kind of has to resonate in me, you know. It gives me some kind of feeling, or it gives me some kind of idea. It just kind of has a tone or a vibe that I feel suits me or feels right for me. So I start with that beat, and what I usually like to do, if I can, is I usually start with the hook, and I work kind of on a hook first, because then I can kind of find like the melody or the idea or the scenario in my head. Because what I find is that in a hook, basically a hook is a summary of the song. It basically summarizes the idea of the song within 4 bars. So once I have the idea of the song, I can develop the verses. And once I have the hook, I find that I can write the verses a lot quicker. Instead of just kind of like writing random bars to something I don't even know where it's going. So,
Do you ever get like an idea, like you just get an inspiration, maybe it's in the middle of the night or something, and you want to write a song about this. And so you all of a sudden have maybe a line or maybe two. And you want to write this song, and now you're trying to meet it up to a beat. Like, is that harder then?
No, that happens a lot. You know, a lot of the girlfriends that I have or I've had, you know, they trip on that, because I'll get up in the middle of the night and I'll be like, I gotta go. I gotta write something down. And they're like, well, you know, who are you talking to on your phone? You know, I write on my phone, right? So that happens a lot to me, Craver. It comes when you least expect it, bro.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah. Thank you guys so much, man. Little sneak peek on Get Off the Couch. What was the name of that track?
A Welcome Home.
That's fresh, eh?
Yeah.
When's that coming out?
That's on the Birds. That's coming out December 6th on Ephin.com. So.
Dope. I love it. I think it sounds great, but I think I don't want to sound rude. I think it could use a little something. I know you haven't heard me before, but I think it could use a little Craver. I think it could use a little Craver.
You want to rap a verse on it?
Yo, turn my snare up, man. Yeah, oh, I'm grooving. Can I get a bit of tuba in there? Can I get a bit of tuba? Drop a bit of tuba in there. Yeah. It's too bright. I need to dim it down a bit. I need to dim it down a bit. I need evil. I need some, yeah.
I can rap now. Okay. Yeah, okay, now I can see it. SDK, get off the couch. 16 bars. My name's Craver. I got a lot of flavor that you can savor. Yo, on a sunny day, grow some hay. Get out of my way. I'm Crave One, and this is what I got to say. Yo, my name is Craver. Check out my sketchbooks. Even brass tacks, they giving me good looks. They checking me out, saying what a fly guy. Yo, bye bye, weak rapper. We got no time for you. Big dollars.
Hey, that's
big.
Enough.
Well, oh, that's enough. It's good.
We've heard.
Yeah, we got it. Hey, did we get it?
That was the one, right?
Yo,
that was the one, right?
Laced out.
That was. Yeah.
Bro,
Oh, oh, right on.
Oh no.
All right. Thanks so much, guys.
Oh yeah. No. Oh, right, totally, man. That was,
I think I killed it.
That was fire.
I think I really killed it.
Yeah. That was.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we're good.
Yeah,
you killed it. Bro.
Yeah, yeah.
We gotta shut it down now, though. Yeah. We gotta go, though.
Oh, yeah, you guys gotta go to bed.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, from here in the booth, at Coast Peak Studios, hometown, Evil Ebenezer. This is where he raps. This is where he does his shit. Getting back to the couch. See you there.
Thanks, Crave. That was good, man.
Yeah, fire. I killed it, man.
Well, you know, like, do you rap a lot? Or?
I sing in the shower.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I'm trying to get by ya. Yeah, I'm trying to get high ya. You know I wouldn't lie to ya. Yeah. Well, actually, I might. Okay. Cause things ain't looking that tight. I need to get us in a better place. Trying to.
Woo!
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Dude, that was a good time, man. Dude, I'm a good rapper.
Oh, fuck, you're...
I had a blast.
You have some heaters, eh?
I'm telling you, man.
You've been working, eh, on this?
I
have you been working on your rap?
I haven't, actually, at all. I haven't at all. I got some of that natural talent, man.
Oh, yeah.
I got...
Keep it up.
You're gonna... That'll be on that album, right?
Yeah, I mean, we gotta check it out and listen to it, but I mean...
Gary Shim... Like, honestly,
where's the John Smiths and the Randy Ortons? Like, where's this, the basic names in there?
There's so many copies.
Where's the John, you know, where's the Larry David?
So evil, I have one question.
Yes.
Do you watch My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic?
I don't watch My Little Pony that much. I was more of a Care Bears guy myself.
Oh, the Care Bears stare?
Come on, like, who didn't flex on the Care Bears? You know what I'm saying? Like that Lionheart, I wanted that mane like he did. You know
what
I'm saying?
Yeah. TJ Murphy.
There you go.
Is it wrong to be like Mike?
No.
Cooper C's. Has anyone ever said you look like Les Stroud?
Who's that?
Dude, I looked it up the other day. Do you know who it is?
No.
The Survivor Man. Have you heard that before? No. Two people commented on that.
Whoa, he's harsh bald, isn't he?
Well, he's a little bit.
I'm good, ladies. I may have a couple silvers, but I'm full head here.
On the Evil Ebenezer, Survivor Man.
I used to watch that show, actually.
Justin Belsky, if you were a jelly bean, what flavor would you be?
Red. There's no doubt in my mind I wouldn't be red.
Mario Medina, Mr. Evil.
Yes.
What would you do for a Klondike bar?
Lick your mama's titty. In less than 2 seconds flat. Moms like me, man. Like, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I'm like polite. Like, I come over. I'm like, I'll even like wash dishes and shit. Like,
I'm polite. Mind,
you know what I mean? Like, you know, I get a bad rap, but like, I'm gonna.
Did you just say I wash dishes?
Well, I just mean I'm not, you know, I'll do what it takes, you know?
I'll do what it takes.
Just slide in, you know what I'm saying? Just one titty, two, not both, because then, you know, you want to keep them in suspense.
All right,
that's a lesson to you kids out there. Don't suck both titties. Pick a titty and suck one titty. Because then she's like, oh, how come you didn't suck my other titty? And they're like thinking about it all night. That's what you do.
Morgan Brainsick. Does Evil have hopes in joining the Illuminati through his music career?
Yes. Sign me up.
Yeah?
I don't even really know what Illuminati
is. You like that New World Order?
I don't even know what that means.
Nick Shaw, does he care if his socks match?
No, Nick, I don't. Because half the time they already have fucking holes in them anyways. My socks are shite. I love getting a brand new pair of socks, so it's like busting a nut. Almost.
That's what I love about Christmas. It's like when you're a kid.
Busting nuts. On the under the Christmas tree.
You got another boo or what?
Sure.
Yeah. I love having a fridge just right here. They have the
caribou, caribou. We thank you so much, Hugo van der Voet.
These things aren't real. These are rap names,
dude. These are full on Facebook.
This guy needs to be a rapper. Say his name again.
Hugo van der Voet,
the poet.
Best brew for the gunnin'. It's a good question.
Boo!
Boo!
Put your fucking antlers on, bitches!
Do something with your life! Get off the goddamn couch, go down to the river and buck a couple boots! You know what I'm saying? Buck a couple boots!
Neil,
you want a buckaboo? Only got a buck or two? Fuck, come down with me and the crew, buck a few! You know how we do?
Big Mercules.
Big Merc wrote
now,
in.
I didn't know what this was about, but I know it's obviously some sort of inside joke. Is this Angoon?
This is Angoon. This is Angoon.
This shall be the summer in your and Admiralty.
This is Angoon.
Hometown of my clean kitchen, 9982. Oh.
This is Angoon.
Is my zip code, code of my state, Alaska.
Shouts out Angoon. All the Ravens and Eagles. Ebenezer loves you, man.
Paolo Bell.
Paolo, talk
evil!
To me.
Exclamation point.
Yes, Paolo.
First off, just want to say you're a fucking beauty.
Thanks, Paolo.
If you could be invisible for one day, what would your day consist of?
Oh, fuck, I'd grab so many titties. You know what? I don't know. I would be a pervert. I would be smacking titties. Sorry, I would be in banks and shit, grabbing loot for the crew. Just grabbing loot and smacking titties, I think the day would consist of those two things.
All right, my homie Jacob, another one from Jacob Shudrostrom. If you had to donate money to an organization, which one would it be?
Probably Boys and Girls Club of Greater Vancouver.
Yeah? Oh, right on.
I used to go there when I was a kid and I had a big brother and shit like that, so probably.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Time for the viewer question! Time for the prize pack. I've got the viewer question right here. This is the one I picked. I like this question because obviously this person had knew a little bit about you, maybe a little bit about your past. This is Dante De Paganon. Dante De Paganon?
Sure.
I heard you made student films. Which was your favorite and why?
Crazy. Well, yeah, I actually did do, I did, what's, oh.
I'm just gonna have another boo.
Oh shit, yeah.
Have a boo
and you. actually I did film and video at university at Capilano College.
Yep.
So yeah, that was good. And I had a couple student films. Which one do I like the best? I don't know.
You did commercials and shit like that?
Oh yeah, I just did commercials and you know, I just kind of learned, you know, I've always been interested in film and stuff like that and doing the videos, hence why, you know, do all the videos and shit like that, so.
Yeah.
Something that I really like to do. The never-ending beer fridge. Well, yeah, I went to school for it. I've always been making videos and films and acting and yep. being behind the camera and just coming up with things. Yeah, I've been doing
that. Is that how you kind of like got into like the rapping thing? Or
yeah,
was that
well, it kind of happened all kind of like at the same time. But like,
yep.
yeah, for a couple years I was going to school and shit. And so I was going to like, you know, probably have, you know, a career like doing that kind of stuff. But then yep. the rapping kind of just took over more.
Right,
so.
Right.
So I just started rapping. But I'll still like, I mean, I'm going to direct a video here coming up. So
Dope. Sticking with it.
Yeah.
If people want to know like how to get a hold of you like online, like want to get to know more about you, where can people go to find you?
Hit me up on evilebenezer.com.
Yep.
Yeah, that's the website. Or hit me up on Facebook, Evil Ebenezer Music.
Dope.
That's the fan page. Or hit me up on Twitter, twitter.com, Evil Ebenezer.
At Evil Ebenezer.
At Evil Ebenezer, that's Dope. Right. Hit me up, brother.
Been a slice, so bro. Been awesome. A slice. Thanks so much for coming out. Much appreciated. Gotta ask you to get your ass off the couch, though.
Peace, man. See you guys later. All the right. Birds, December 6th. Go get it.
That's right. December 6th, The Birds, Evil Ebenezer. He's releasing a brand new, fresh album. It's all free. It'll be on effin.com, you guys. Had a lot of brews. I'm good to go. I think this is the end of the episode. So for me, Crave One, and all of the SDK effin family, I'm gonna say peace. I'm out. Get off the couch, baby.